In this TCPIP basics video, we're going to talk about what is a network. Well, here's a picture of a network diagram, and actually we see three different networks, and they're all separated and connected using a layer 3 switch or a router. So what a router does is it allows us to communicate between different networks or subnets, and it does all of the routing so it can tell which network should be getting the traffic and which shouldn't be getting the traffic. A layer 3 switch does the same thing. It has built-in routing capabilities. It just has a lot more ports. And instead of using subnets, it uses what's called virtual LANs. So it works the exact same way as a router does. It routes between different networks. And without getting too technical about layer 3 switching and virtual LANs in this particular video, let's concentrate on the three different networks that you see here. We have an accounting network, an HR network, and an IT network. And you can see each of them have their own /29 CIDR address as well. And we talked about CIDR addresses or what that means in previous videos in this playlist. So if you didn't see that yet, go ahead and check it out so you can understand what that means. So what is a network? Well, in this case, one of our networks is a 192.168.1.0/29 network. Let's break that down a little bit. This is what that subnet mask, that /29, looks like in binary. So, you know, we have to have 32 bits of data because an IPv4 address is 2 to the 32nd power. So if we're going to mask out the first 29 bits of the IP address for our network, then this is what that looks like. You see 29 ones all in a row followed by 3 zeros. So on the left-hand side, those are all the networks that we can have. And in the previous diagram, you can see 3 total networks. But we, of course, could have a lot more than that because we have 29 bits worth, or 2 to the 29th power. But then we have only 3 bits for the hosts, for our host devices, our computers. So the value of those last 3 bits, if you remember when we talked in a previous video about how to come up with the value of binary to decimal, you can see that the first bit all the way to the right, the value is 1. The second bit, the value is 2. And the third bit is 4. And of course, they double every bit you go from right to left. But in this case, we only have 3 bits to work with. So we have a total of 4, 5, 6, 7 addresses. That is our total in this particular network. So 7 minus 1, so we need to account for the broadcast address, gives us 6 usable IP addresses. So that means we could use IP address 1 through 6. And then the 7th is going to be our broadcast. Now, we talked about previous videos where we're supposed to subtract 2 IP addresses, not just 1. And that's because we added this using binary rather than the 2 to the 3rd power. So we see 3 bits. We know that that's 2 to the 3rd power. Well, 2 to the 3rd power equals 8, not 7. So we need to subtract 2 if we're going to go by the power of 2. So we do 2 to the 3rd power equals 8 minus 2, and then we subtract the broadcast and the network address, and we still get 6 usable IP addresses. So it depends on which way you're going to add up the network IP addresses and the host IP addresses on whether or not you subtract those 2 out of the usable IP addresses. Are you going to add it up in binary, like you see in the middle of the screen? Well, only subtract 1 address. Are you going to add up using the power of 2? Okay, that's fine. Subtract 2 addresses. And that's because when you add up in binary, the number zero is assumed. So in our particular case, our first number, 1.0, that's an actual address, not a usable one, but it is an address of our network. That one is assumed when we go through binary. So it's totally up to you. There's 2 different ways to get to the same answer. So what do we do with the next network? Well, we started at .8. We've used 0 through 7 already. Now we're going to start 8 for the next subnet or network address. So let's take a look once again at our 3 networks. We've got 1.0 at the top, We've got 1.8 because that's where we start our second network. And then we have 1.16 because that's where we start our third network. There's 8 addresses total minus the 2. If we're going by the powers of 2, then we get our network addresses that we see there. They're usable addresses. So we see the router in the center of the screen. And once again, the router is the thing that separates our three networks, but it also brings them together as well. And if you decide to, you can use the layer 3 switching using VLANs. Now there's a third option, and that is if you're doing this all with virtual machines. So if you're doing with virtual machines, what's cool is you don't actually need real physical hardware. You do need at least one network card, and 2 is preferable, but you could create as many virtual switches as you would like. You can make as many layer 3 virtual switches using one physical network card. So when we get into Hyper-V or VMware or some of these other products that are out there, you can use the software switch option to save yourself a lot of money so you don't need to buy a lot of extra hardware. The network side of an IP address can be expanded or contracted based on the subnet mask. Stay tuned for additional videos as we talk about supernetting, subnetting, anding, and other great topics that will also be covered on the Network Plus certification test.